Now, as promised, a special comment on the madness of the Tea Party and the elections of next Tuesday. It is as if a group of moderately talented performers has walked on stage at a comedy club on improv night. Each hears a shout from the audience consisting of a bizarre but just barely plausible fear or hatred or neurosis or prejudice. And the entertainment of the evening is for each to take their thin, absurd premise and build upon it, a campaign for governor or congressman or senator. The problem is, of course, when it turns out that there is no audience shouting out gags, just a cabal of corporations and the U.S. Chamber of Commerce and political insider bloodsuckers like Karl Rove and Dick Armey and the Chicken Little chorus of Rush Limbaugh and Glenn Beck. And the instructions are not to improvise a comedy sketch, but to elect a group of unqualified, unstable individuals who will do what they are told in exchange for money and power and march this nation as far backward as they can get. Backward to Jim Crow, or backward to the breadlines of the 30s, or backward to hanging union organizers, or backward to the trusts and the robber barons. Result? The Tea Party. Vote backward. Vote Tea Party. And if you are somehow indifferent to what is planned for next Tuesday, it is nothing short of an attempted use of democracy to end this democracy, to buy America wholesale and pave over the freedoms and the care we take of one another, which have combined to keep us the envy of the world. You do not think your freedom is at stake next Tuesday? The Tea Party and Republican candidate for Senator from Nevada, Sharon Angle, just decried divorce and Social Security as some of this nation's, quote, wicked ways. Mrs. Angle also compared rape to, quoting, lemon in a lemon situation in lemonade. She would deny an abortion even to a teenage girl who had been raped by her own father. The Tea Party and Republican candidate to be the only congressman in Delaware, Glenn Urquhart, said there is no problem that abortion can't make worse. I know good friends who are the product of rape. Mr. Urquhart also says he does not believe the phrase separation of church and state was said by Thomas Jefferson. He thinks it was Hitler. The next time your liberal friends ask you about the separation of church and state, ask them why they are Nazis. The Tea Party and Republican candidate in the Ohio 9th, Rich Iatt, not only ran around in a Nazi uniform celebrating their military tactics, but implies he is a veteran, and as late as this March listed his occupation as soldier, even though the volunteer militia to which he belongs has never been called, will never be called, to any active service in the 29 years in which he has belonged to it. Mr. Iatt now claims Mr. Boehner is campaigning with him over the final days. It's more than just dress up. They mean business, literally. The Tea Party and Republican candidate for New Jersey's third House seat, John Runyon, defended corporate tax loopholes. Loopholes are there for a reason. They are to avoid people from really having to pay too many taxes. The Tea Party and Republican candidate for the Senate in West Virginia, John Racey, explained, quote, I made my money the old-fashioned way. I inherited it. I think that's a great thing to do. I hope more people in this country have that opportunity as soon as we abolish inheritance tax in this country. The inheritance tax applies only to estates larger than $3.5 million. For the 99.8% of Americans not affected by the estate tax, there is the minimum wage, which Mr. Racey also wants abolished, or there is Social Security. The Tea Party and Republican candidate in the Indiana 9th, Todd Young, says Social Security, as so many of you know, is a Ponzi scheme. The Tea Party and Republican candidate in the Wisconsin 8th, Reed Dribble, disagrees. Social Security is, in fact, a Ponzi scheme. The Tea Party and Republican candidate in the Arizona 8th, Jesse Kelly, wants to resurrect President Bush's scam to transform Social Security into private investment accounts so the government can force you to spend part of your paycheck on Wall Street commissions and so that market manipulators can wipe out your retirement money. The Republican candidate in the Wisconsin 1st, Congressman Paul Ryan, has a more sophisticated plan. Personal investment Social Security guaranteed dollar for dollar by the government. A fiscal fountain of youth. Until you find out its cost. Ryan would pay for it by taxing the health insurance you get from your employer. If you are not employed, Mrs. Angle of Nevada says unemployment benefits can neither be increased nor extended because that has caused us to have a spoilage with our ability to go out and get a job. There are jobs that do exist. That's what we're saying, is that there are jobs. The Tea Party and Republican candidate for Senator in Alaska, Joe Miller, says this is academic because unemployment insurance is unconstitutional. His own wife received unemployment insurance after losing a temp job he got for her. Mr. Miller also called Medicaid unconstitutional. It proved his entire family had received Medicaid funds. Mr. Miller also claims Social Security is unconstitutional, yet hypocritically he says it should still be paid out, and then the entire issue dumped into the laps of the states. The Republican and Tea Party candidate for senator in Colorado, Ken Buck, would not stop at butchering just Social Security. Would a Veterans Administration hospital that is run by the private sector be better run than by the public sector? In my view, yes. The Tea Party and Republican candidate in the Pennsylvania 4th, Keith Rothfuss, has promised to overturn anything the Supreme Court decides with which he disagrees. Congress's ultimate weapon is funding. If the Supreme Court rules you have to do something, we'll just take away the funding for it. Back in Nevada, Mrs. Engel decries health care reform and also health care itself. Everything that they want to throw at us, she says, is now covered under, quote, autism. As to educating those children, Mrs. Engel will not pay for. Mr. Buck of Colorado waxes nostalgic. In the 1950s, we had the best schools in the world, and the United States government decided to get more involved in federal education. Well, since we've made education worse, we're going to get even more involved. In Ken Buck's America of 1957, fewer than one in five black children graduated high school. Fewer than half of white children did. To the Tea Party and Republican candidate in the California 11th, David Harmer, Mr. Buck is a wild-eyed liberal. Mr. Harmer once advocated eliminating public schools altogether and returning education into this country into where it was before 1876. People acting in a free market found a variety of ways to pay for a variety of schools, serving a variety of students, all without central command or control. And without girls, blacks, or even the slightest chance you could go to college. The Tea Party and Republican candidate in the Virginia 11th, Keith Femian, is not so sure we need a federal bureaucracy for education. The Tea Party and Republican candidate in the Florida 2nd, Steve Sutherland, wants to defund the Department of Education because we can't afford it. The Tea Party and Republican candidate in the Texas 17th, Bill Flores, offers a trifecta plus a delusion. Get rid, he says, of the Pornographic Endowment of the Arts, Department of Energy, Department of Education, and with them, he says, ACORN. ACORN, which went out of business last April 1st. The Tea Party and Republican candidate in the Arizona 5th, David Schweikert, is passionately, he says, trying to eliminate the Department of Education because it's, quote, unconstitutional. And while one of the few threads uniting the ragamuffins who constitute the slate of Tea Party candidates is so-called strict interpretation of that Constitution, Mr. Miller of Alaska wants, in fact, to change the Constitution. He wants to repeal the 17th Amendment. The Tea Party and Republican candidate for Senate from Utah, Mike Lee, called that 17th Amendment a mistake. Last year, Mr. Buck of Colorado said the 17th Amendment took us down the wrong path. The 17th Amendment, of course, permits the direct election by the voters of U.S. senators. Buck and Lee and Miller not only demand you elect them to the Senate now, they then hope to deny you the right to elect somebody else next time. The ubiquitous Mrs. Engel, meanwhile, wants to repeal the 16th Amendment. It provided for a federal income tax. Mrs. Engel does not explain how, without that tax, the federal government would pay for keeping out the Mexicans she specifically attacks in her newest commercial. The Tea Party and Republican candidate for senator from Kentucky, Rand Paul, wishes to repeal the 14th Amendment because it interferes with a private business's right to ban black people from its premises, and also because it allows anyone born here in America to be American. He is worried about anchor babies. The Republican candidate for the 1st District of Texas, Louie Gohmert, fears not anchor babies, but terror babies, unborn infants brought to this country in the womb, ready for American citizenship and pre-programmed to blow things up 15 or 20 years from now. Curiously, Mr. Gohmert has not been asked if he is in favor of aborting them. The Tea Party and Republican candidate for governor of Arizona, Jan Brewer, sees not terror fetuses, but headless bodies in endless deserts murdered by immigrants who are nearly all drug mules. The Tea Party and Republican candidate for governor of Colorado, Dan Mays, believes a bike-sharing program is part of a plot to turn Denver into a metropolis run by the United Nations. The Tea Party and Republican candidate for Senate from Delaware, Christine O'Donnell, believes she was cleared to read secret classified documents about China because she's been working for nonprofit organizations for the past 15 years. She also believes China is plotting to take over the United States, and the first evidence of this is that, quote, China is drilling for oil off the coast of Florida. This fear of the Chinese clearly does not extend, though, to the Tea Party and Republican candidate for Senate from Illinois, Mark Kirk. One day, he held a fundraiser with American businessmen in China. The next day, he voted against closing tax incentives for outsourcing American jobs to places like China. The Tea Party and Republican candidate for Senate from Wisconsin, Ron Johnson, is also in favor of relocating employees. He testified against toughening laws on pedophiles and employers who shield them. He argued this could damage a business like the Catholic Church. In Utah, the anti-bailout Senate candidate, Mr. Lee, insists on not raising the liability limits for the next BP from $75 million to $10 billion. You have a set of settled expectations that you give to a business when it decides to make an investment in this. Our country benefits from this type of activity. Asked by the Salt Lake City Tribune if that's a kind of bailout, if it leaves taxpayers on the hook for part of the damage, Lee admitted, well, yeah, probably does. Mr. Paul.